enjoy the power. Because, you see, without power, I am nothing. I have to own my power because no one else is gonna do it for me. So, I own my pillar on the southwest corner of the garden. This is my home. This is my garden.
I'm Julie Wyman. I'm producer, director, writer, creator of How We Look.
Hi, and I'm Sophia Cheyenne, producer, writer, director, creator of How We Look.
You think you're better than me? You think because I stand here all day long on my feet and my broken...
I have a rare form of dwarfism. I'm also a performing artist. So my connection to this project is my lived experience as an LP and as an artist.
I have a pretty unusual story in that I'm a taller dwarf. I have shorter arms and legs and a longer torso, and my whole life I've wondered if I had a form of dwarfism. You know, all my films have been about people whose bodies don't fit in some way and who push against that. And that's really driven by my lived experience in this body that didn't quite fit.
You by bulk literally just took mine. I was gonna do swimming and then I was gonna do salsa dance.
Oh, so now what happened?
My parents knew that I was a little person when I was born. And so I've always owned that identity. I've never met someone like Julie that was passionate about how stories depict people with dwarfism. There's plenty of us that believe that it should change, but who are the change makers?
Look at my little fingers.
Like,
look at her. She's dead.
I think we kind of imagined a time and space where we could think about what is dwarf culture, what do we share, what legacy are we a part of, what future do we hope for, do we fear?
That's definitely an approach. I think that person.
Safe spaces to help the group of artists openly talk about our history and how we have been seen in media and in Hollywood. While we've been here, we've actually traced our bodies and looked at ourselves. We've also tangibly looked at images of court dwarfs, images of the carnival, images of the freak shows.
Each person got to choose one painting, photograph, you know, broadside from a carnival show, and look at a person and bring their actor skills to imagining and bringing agency to that pictured person. And then this week in September, we've come together with a film crew and shot the distilled, synthesized scripts that come from those explorations. One of my early discoveries, kind of connecting to Little People community, has been like, this isn't a community of people who are starved for attention. This is a community of people that are being ogled, stared, laughed at, like seen as entertainment since the beginning of time. And so it really is about a power shift and like asking, is it possible for us to use this act of showing and being seen? Can we intervene in that? Can we take control? Can we find our power in that and in our history?